Hi girls and boys, it's Bobby here from Rise Rooted Wellness, and I would like to wish you a very warm welcome to our first ever episode of Kids Corner. Now in Kids Corner, you will find a range of stories and activities that are all inspired by nature and to the changing seasons. And today I've chosen a story called Bee. And I've chosen that because I don't know about you, but I've certainly been seeing a lot more bees around lately. And this is a beautiful story that my children and I all love, and I really hope that you will enjoy it too. So before I start to read the story, you might want to take a moment to get yourself nice and comfortable. You could sit by a window looking out. Maybe you can spot a bee while I'm reading. You could close your eyes and relax while you listen to the story. Or you could watch the video and see the beautiful illustrations throughout the book. I'll leave that for you to choose. Bee by Britta Teckentrup. Dawn is breaking on a brand new day, and in the meadow poppies sway. A bee appears, striped black and gold. A wonder of nature is about to unfold. In the treetops, birds start to sing. The little bee beats her wings. As she travels here and there, a gentle thrumming fills the air. Back and forth, to-ing and fro-ing, the bee knows exactly where she's going. Visiting flowers of every hue, she has a special job to do. Gathering nectar as she goes, from every foxglove, every rose. Dusty with pollen, the little bee buzzes, buzzes busily. Bee travels on from bloom to bloom, drawn in by their sweet perfume. Harvesting flowers one by one, her compass is the midday sun. Among the orchard's apple trees, blossom quivers in the breeze. Carrying pollen from place to place, bee always leaves a tiny trace. Flowers as far as the eye can see, too many flowers for just one bee. All of a sudden, bee is gone. She has a message to pass on. Back at the hive, bee spreads the news. There's work to be done, no time to lose. Listen for their gentle humming. The word is out. The bees are coming. Buzzing over the dense hedgerows, past the pond where wild thyme grows. Through the orchard's sweet-smelling scent, the bees travel on with calm intent. As lilies glow orange in the sun, the bees must finish what they've begun. Stopping at every flower they find, leaving the gift of pollen behind. The bees pass over a woodland stream, droplets sparkle and pebbles gleam. Water trickles, bubbles and weaves, a weeping willow trails its leaves. As the bees fly on through buds and burrs, a tiny miracle occurs. For every plant and flower you see was given life by one small bee. Now, isn't that a beautiful story? I hope you enjoyed it. And I wonder how many bees you might spot the next time you're out in your garden or on a walk. Now, as you can see, bees are very, very important. And there are a few things that we can do to help the bees to really thrive. So I've got a few inspired ideas that you may wish to do at home. The first thing you can do is make sure there's always some fresh water for them, because all that flying around is surely going to make them thirsty. So it's always nice for them to have some fresh water to drink. The other thing you can do is make sure that your mummy and daddy aren't using harmful pesticides, because that's one of the worst things in the world for the bees, and it's really, really sad. There are greener, safer options available out there. Another fun thing you can do is plant lots of beautiful flowers or scatter wild flower seeds in different areas of the garden and just see what flowers come up. The birds will really love that, and I'm sure you'll enjoy watching the flowers grow too. That's all from me today. I hope you've enjoyed the first episode. I've certainly enjoyed reading for you and sharing some ideas. I will see you again very soon. Have a wonderful day.